In this video, we will discuss the top 7 best binoculars for stargazing. So let's get started. Number 7. Celestron Echelon 20x70. Celestron's large aperture Echelon 20x70 binoculars work exceptionally well in low light conditions, which is great if you plan on exploring the Milky Way. They have an exit pupil of 3.5 millimeters, which delivers a substantial amount of light so you can make out small details. It's an ideal tool for observing tiny items at long distances, as well as magnifying celestial objects. The binoculars are assembled in California, while the 70mm objective lenses are made in Japan. The Bach 4 prisms provide excellent contrast and sharpness, and the air-to-glass surfaces are covered in the brand's XLT optical coating for additional contrast and resolution. They're made of aluminum alloy for strength and to keep the weight down. Number 6. Goski 10x42 Roof. The Goski Roof Prism binoculars are another good product. These strong binoculars come with a powerful 10x magnification and 42mm objective lens for better visibility of space. One of the best things about them is that they are built with a roof prism that makes them more compact. One interesting feature of these particular binoculars is that the glass is made out of a multi-layer green coat. This boosts their performance and makes them a bit tougher. Another great addition to these binoculars is their included smartphone mount. This allows you to easily set up the binoculars without constantly looking through the viewfinder. Number 5. Orion Scenix Wide. For binoculars named after a constellation, these are excellent to use for peering up at the stars. They feature large lenses that boast a 7x magnification lens, as well as a 50mm objective lens for better light filtration. They also include high-quality BAK 4 poro prisms and multi-coated lenses for crisper images. One benefit is its lightweight and extremely portable design. Their lens design provides a pristine and clear image of the stars and filters light evenly for a sharp image. Other high points are the strong and durable metal casing that reduces the chances of them getting scratched or broken if dropped. They also function well with glasses and work well in low light. Number 4. Sky Genius 10x50 Binoculars. These binoculars from Sky Genius are great for stargazing. They have a 50mm, 40mm, and 32mm lens diameter. They have an ocular lens and are made of slip-proof materials, so you can enjoy nature even in humid or rainy conditions. They have a range of 376 feet to 1,000 yards. With a wide field of view, it makes it easier to capture fast-moving subjects like birds. These are designed to make it easy to see during twilight or even at night for stargazing. They are shock-resistant, so if you do accidentally drop them, they will be protected against possible damage. The rubber-covered eyepiece is also adjustable for different face shapes and sizes. Topping it off, these are quite affordable for binoculars. Number 3. Optic Ron Adventure 2. Sometimes, when optical instruments are being designed, consideration is not always given to astronomers who wear spectacles. These observers often find that their eyes cannot get as close to the eye cups or eyepieces of binoculars and telescopes, forcing them to remove their glasses for a comfortable view. The Optic Ron Adventure 2 WP10x50 binocular is the perfect solution for spectacle wearers, since an excellent eye relief of 0.7 inches, 17.78 millimeters, is offered, eye relief being the distance from the eyepiece at which the user can still see the entire field of view. The binocular also features twistable eye cups that can retract or extend, making the Optic Ron Adventure 2 WP10x50 more comfortable, whether you wear glasses or not. Number 2. Vortex Optics Crossfire. The sturdy, well-constructed Vortex 10x50 Crossfire HD binocular is primarily intended for terrestrial observations or watching wildlife in action. That's not to say that they can't be turned skyward, though. Through the field of view, the sights are crisp and clear, with stars appearing as perfect pinpoints of light. However, we did detect a degree of false color when observing brighter targets, the Moon and Jupiter, for example, were tinged with a blue to purple hue around their outer edges. It's worth noting that this optical defect isn't unusual at this price point. Additionally, our views of the night sky were not ruined, and we enjoyed our tour with the Vortex 10x50 Crossfire HD. Number 1. Celestron 71336. This relatively unusual combination of 12x magnification and 56mm aperture objective lenses combines power with light gathering ability, while still being small and light enough to be handheld comfortably with steady hands. It's noticeable how better they show galaxies than smaller models. The Andromeda Galaxy, Messier 31, appears disc-shaped with hints of structure, while the neighboring Bodes Galaxy, Messier 81, and Cigar Galaxy, Messier 82, in Ursa Major, the Great Bear, look outstanding in the same 5.5-degree field of view. Turned towards the Moon, the craters exude superb clarity and contrast. There is a slight amount of distortion through the optical system that begins about 3/4 of the way from the center of the field, with some stars displaying a degree of softness. These stars took the appearance of blobs rather than points of light. The Celestron Nature DX 12x56 is waterproof and also keeps fogging at bay.